So let's look at our answer to the UMA SMP quiz. We want to have a lot of cores with this type of architecture. So what are the problems that we'll have to face? The memory will need to be large and slow, and that's because having more cores usually means that we will be running programs that access more data, and we need to keep that data somewhere. So we will need to have a large memory, and that makes the memory slow. Next, that memory will get too many accesses per second because the cache misses from all of the cores will be going to memory. If one of the core generates cache misses that the memory can survive doing, two of them, it might still survive, but if we have a lot of cores, our memory will probably not be able to keep up with all of those accesses. We'll need a lot of small memory modules, not necessarily. The number of memory modules in a centralized memory doesn't matter. What is really needed is to have enough memory for all the cores to get enough data in there, and the memory that will keep up with the bandwidth demands of the cores. How many modules we have doesn't really matter. Caches will have very small block size. This is not true either. All of the caches in all of the cores can have any block size they want. The block size is not divided among the cores. Pages for virtual memory become too small, same thing. We can have any page size we want. Having more or fewer cores doesn't affect the page size in virtual memory. So the only options you should have selected are the first two.